Hello engineers, this is one mechanical engineer and today I will talk about open cycle gas turbine power plants. Actually, I have talked about open cycle gas turbine power plant in classification of gas turbine power plants, but I will talk about in deep in this video. And in this video I will also tell you why should we use open cycle gas turbine power plant and why we should not use open cycle gas turbine power plant. And in other words, I will tell you advantages and disadvantages of open cycle gas turbine. So without wasting time, let's get started. To explain open cycle gas turbine power plant properly, I would like to draw something here. Let's focus camera here. This is our compressor. And from here, air gets sucked in. This is our compressor, and from here air gets sucked in this compressor. This is air, right? And here there is one filter is given. This filter removes air and dust from this air, and after this air comes in this position. This is the compressor, and compressor always get connected to our gas turbine. This is our gas turbine. I will talk about gas turbine later. Right now I will talk about compressor. When it get come into compressor, there are some blades here. I am not drawing it properly because I am very lazy person, and I will always stay lazy person. And when it get compressed by using these blades, and after it get compressed, pressure of this air get increased, and after it compressed air with high pressure goes into combustion chamber. This is our combustion chamber. I am not drawing it properly because I am very lazy person, as I said before. This is our combustion chamber. And from here, compressed air get into this combustion chamber. And from here, fuels comes in our combustion chamber. And fuel and air get mixed and it is used as working medium. And this working medium is called a product of gases. And if these gases comes inside of gas turbine, and before it comes inside the gas turbine, it get burned in here, gas in the combustion chamber. And when it get burned, temperature of it get increases. So this is not that much good. We really need here heat energy, but we don't need that much heat energy, because if we will use that much heat energy, then our blades of turbine, our gas turbine blades might not stay excessive, and we don't want it to become excessive. I mean, we want it to stay excessive, right? So we have to decrease the temperature. So how it get done? It is achieved by allowing remainder air to enter the combustion chamber at downstream. Enter the combustion chamber at downstream to mix and cool down the combustion gases. And after that, it rotate the blades. This gas rotate this blade. And when it get rotated, we use this energy to generate our electricity. And larger part of heat used up to compress the air, and after it get used up, after it get expanded here, it get ejected to the atmosphere. So this is it in open cycle gas turbine power plant. So what are the advantages in open cycle gas turbine power plant? Actually, main advantage of open cycle gas turbine power plant is it is very very means very simple design. there are few rotating parts, blade, shaft and blade, and this rotating part rotates this to produce this electricity. So problem of vibration and lubrication is not that much in open cycle gas turbine power plant. And one other advantage is that the weight of this gas turbine power plant is very less as compared to power generated by this gas turbine power plant. And one other advantage is that it does not require any cooling boiler. And if we are using intercooler in these combustion chambers, then we will definitely use cooling water. But we normally, if we don't provide any intercooler, then we don't we need cooling water. And we can use all the fuels. Which fuels we can use? We can use all the hydrocarbon fuels. From octane gasoline to diesel oil, and we can also use some solid fuel for burning in our gas chamber. And when we start this gas turbine, once it pick up its speed and it start burning this mixture of fuel and air, we don't need to do anything. It works at its fuel efficiency. So it is very quick, and it is normally used when we need a gas turbine power plant in emergency. So this is particularly used for emergency. So what are the, so just I told you how, why should we use gas turbine power plant. Now I will tell you why we should not use. We can also tell it, this is disadvantages. If you will read any book, then you will find many disadvantages, but I think those are not that much affected disadvantages. And main disadvantage is that most of this part which we use here, power generated from here, mostly most of energy generated used in compressor. So we lose all of those energy, and humidity, because of humidity it get affected, because it is depends on atmosphere. We use air, so it depends on atmosphere, so because of it is very sensitive system. And second disadvantage is that here is filter is provided, and this filter cannot remove all the dust. And because of that, some particles of dust and carbon get deposited on these blades, and little part of those dust and carbon get deposited on these blades. So we have to remove it again and again. So it is quite expensive. And after we use this air, and after this air get expanded here, it get ejected to atmosphere, and it is very high heat energy, and we lose all of those heat energy without any reason. We cannot use that heat energy again. So that is one major disadvantage of gas turbine power plant, I mean open cycle gas turbine power plant. So this was it for gas turbine, I mean open cycle gas turbine power plant. Now you can get lost.